about filmmaking? What is like one of very famous directors nowadays? And he's starting a very big Hollywood movie, which is coming out this year. And I want to make jewelry from recycling products. And I realized that Africans are really, really innovative because they don't have much, so they have to make use of what they have. So they can like use all the newspaper also and make jewelry, and they can sell them. And they're really pretty. And I learned that from them. I learned about Tibetan Buddhism when I was staying with a Tibetan family, and I had a chance to meet Dalai Lama. And I also learned about gambling. Actually, I don't like great gambling according to science of probation. The science of probability. Sorry, I mentioned myself. So I learned about the science when I was working for a casino in Tanzania. So what I want to say is that, how important traveling is to education by this quote from St. Augustine. The world is a book, and those who do not travel read only one page. I still don't want to show this picture because I don't really recognize myself here. But what I want to say is that traveling helps me to understand myself more. Because if you stay home and you meet the same people every day, we go to the same places every day, we face the same situations every day. So we don't have a chance to put ourselves in different situations to understand ourselves. For example, I used to think of myself as a very nice girl. But until somebody started giving me like high price or something harassed me, it's just stood around and stabbed me in the face. I realized I wasn't nice. Or when after I was almost kidnapped, I realized I was pretty brave as well. So traveling helps me a lot to understand myself, what I can do, what I cannot do. But I know that I'm very lucky to be one of very few people my age from developing countries that can travel. There are many reasons to it. First, it's money. It's very simple. It's money. A lot of people in Vietnam don't believe in my story whatsoever because they don't think that they can make enough money to travel. They think that it's going to cost a lot of money. All about culture. Anybody can read this comic? It's a Vietnamese one, so I can say in Vietnamese this comic, but it doesn't make any sense in Vietnamese in English. Khi mình về nhà thì mọi người thường hay bảo bố mẹ mình hay bảo là thế bao giờ mày mới ở nhà mày lấy chồng, thì mình hay bảo bố mẹ là thôi mẹ kiếm được con và anh làm con ngoại hiền lành thì con cưới về nhà cho xong bố mẹ con đi tiếp. So it's about the culture thing. When I tell them a travel girl, they ask me, do you have a job there? Do you go to study there? Or do you have a family there? I said no. I said, what's that? So why do you travel there? They have no idea. The idea of traveling just to experience, to see the world, that's not it. People don't understand it, therefore they try to prevent you from doing that. So what I believe is that money, for the first thing, money. I can say that sometimes money is very important, but sometimes money is not everything. I started the trip when I had only $700. And that's how people started calling me the $700 girl. And I got very, very upset because, come on, I was a cheat. And about the cultural thing, I think it can change. When people see more of the benefits of traveling, then they may see traveling with a better outlook, like a new outlook, and they will accept it more. But I want to propose this thing, it's a visa barrier. Anybody knows what's index? It's a Huyen visa restriction index. It ranks the country passport in terms of the freedom when it comes, in terms of freedom to travel here. You can see that Vietnam doesn't rank very high, it's only ranked higher than Iran, Nepal, Lebanon, Pakistan, Afghanistan, like those countries having civil wars. It's hard sometimes for people from Europe or from America to understand our pain, like those people, or even people from Japan, or Japan. Chinese people have a very good passport. So it's hard for people to understand our pain. But some people who have been to Vietnam can understand that. Like when I was in Egypt, and I met an American, and he was like, I cannot believe that I can live until one day I can see a Vietnamese traveler. But he never believed, he never thought of Vietnamese from travel. So it's like everybody has ever applied for a visa. Do you even know how painful it is? So it's like we cannot be spontaneous. It takes a time and effort. Like we have to try really hard for it. And sometimes when I apply visa, I can have to go to the embassy like 10 times. Like even they are really far away. And I have to like use all resources, ask friends for recommendation, invitation letter, and hotel booking, whatsoever. But they can still not get it. Like so many times I've been to those, like where I was in Middle East, I was in Israel. I could see all the nearby countries, like from the border, I could see Syria, I could see Lebanon, but I could not cross the border to go there because there's something like invisible barrier in that. Even and in that case my friends can just work it, they don't even need to worry about anything. But so I understand the reason. A lot of people are like the reason for visa barrier is for the security reason. Because we're afraid that people from developing countries might come in and like stay and get illegal jobs. Or they even like commit some crimes and stuff. I'm not sure because you can say that, can you really say that people from Vietnam or from Nepal or from Cambodia has a higher tendency to commit crime? Can you really say that? Or even if it's true, like how many, it's just a minority. I'm pretty sure that 90% people are still like good people and commit crime. But somehow we are categorized in that. It's like, or first of all, like it's like a country, like a rich friend. Like a rich friend only allows his rich friend to come in because he doesn't want his poor friends to steal things from his house. It's very unfair. So I don't know how to call it. It's like a country A to that. Okay, if from England you can come in. If from Vietnam, come over here. No, you cannot. Just get out. So what is this like? So the only difference here is our country tag. It's something that like we have no control over. It's like we are being punished for being born in a wrong country. But being born to parents with wrong citizenship. It's something that we could not have chosen. Who could have chosen what country we were born in? Nobody could. It's something that we're just being punished for it. And what I'm so upset about is that, or even more upset, is that people, our current attitude toward it is just that deal with it. Just like accept it. Nobody does, like we accept it as a fact of life. As a fact, like we are not doing anything about it. So what I want to say today is that we have to see it as a real problem. There is an inequality there, and we need to do something about it. I don't know how exactly, but it's more than what I could imagine. But I propose a foundation. It's controlling is an equal opportunity foundation. The initial is wrong. It's T-E-O, if not T-O. Yeah. So T-O. It's like, the first thing I want people to realize is a problem. I want to have a petition for those who understand it's a problem to raise their voice. And those who are suffering from this inequality to raise their voice. And the second is, I want to set up a foundation to support the visas for those who are members. It's not that easy. Like we have to have a very good screening process to see like who can become a member and how to make sure that those members are good people, those who commit crimes or stay illegally or get a job illegally. I don't know how exactly, but I can see a very good model from Isaac. A very good model to get the members. Maybe you can give something better than that. And then with that, we can appeal to UN on all the countries. For example, maybe we can appeal to like the US to accept our members as the TUF members. And we can go for other countries as well. If we have each country support, then our members can go to the country with easier visa policy. So I know it's not as simple as it is. It takes a lot of time. It's a lot bigger than I am. Then it's a lot bigger than I am. And a lot of my friends think that I'm crazy. A lot of people think that I'm crazy. But it's okay to be crazy, it doesn't matter. So I know that like it might not be the best solution. But I want people to see that there is a problem there. And if there is a problem, there must be a solution. If my solution is not good enough, then we have to come up with another solution. As long as we are working together towards it. So I hope that you realize the problem and maybe you can support me in it. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you very much. Thank you very much. So, did you get any good ideas from their presentation?
Much.
Much. Is their ideas light on your heart? So, next is our turn. So we, I think, recuperate innovative ideas. So before going to co-creation sessions, so please give your massive applause to all of the presenters again.